potencial o geotermal potencial of the Euroregion. The potential of shallow geothermal it depends how many mass we can extract from the soil or reinject into the soil. Okay. As Daniel commented before, we can use shallow geothermal in every place that we can make a grid. Okay. But the major what we find on our ground is dominated by the anomalies of the lithosphere. These anomalies are controlled by faults, horse gravels, young mountains, deep sedimentary basins, volcanic systems, and thermal springs. These anomalies in the surface we can find in this little structural map of the Euroregion that the rift of the continent place makes these figures. We have inverse faults, we have normal faults here, and inverse faults here. These systems make thinnest the lithosphere structures, and in this place we have the hot temperature underground, near in the surface. Okay. Then, if you see the map of France. These systems, the outgroups in the surface are represented by thermal springs and volcanoes. These points, the colors are not very clear, but these points are thermal springs associated to the inverse faults. The deep basins are controlled by the normal faults in a rift and host grabbing system, this one also, and this in the center of France we have a very clear volcanic magmatic system with a little outcrops of thermal springs. In other area of the Euroregion, like Catalonia, we see the same. We see the outcrops of thermal springs controlled by the inverse faults. The normal faults control this kind of thermal and hydrothermal systems. This one is another, associated to a deep basin, sedimentary basin. And this one is related to a quaternary volcanoid system with ancient transversal faults. All the deep geothermal systems that we could see in the surface, and the bigger systems are in the surface, only we can see these manifestations. In the Balearic Islands, these outgroups manifestations, it's only located in San Juan, in the southern part of the island. This is the only outcrop of thermal spring that we can relate with high temperature systems. The other things are wells drilled to take water upstreams for the agriculture, and we can locate these points in the few hundreds at the bottom of the surface. The major ones is this one in Zona Major, where we reach at the bottom 51 degrees centigrade at 100 meters below. All of this data is all of the data in consequence are well known and are exploited or investigated by the business, by the mining companies to extract energy from them. Then that well, mining concessions in the Euroregion are in Mallorca we have only one grid area of concession called Section D, resource Section D in the Spanish law of mining that is associated to the energetic resource. Concretely is D1. D3, D7 is related to lignite or carboniferous or another kind of energetic commodities. Then, and actually, we have only a big area of exploration in Mallorca, like in Catalonia. These areas of exploration, and I repeat, deep geothermal systems with high temperature to catch to make electricity. It is actually only in the phase of exploration, and are these ones in Catalonia, here in the basin of Vic, here in the zone of volcanic overload, and the relation and with the rift of Valles Penedès, these areas are either investigated by the companies. But I repeat, it is only an exploration phase.
No, sí que va, però a vegades va lent. No fa falta que et pompis, no va per infrarroig. Apreta un cop I espera, perquè la plantilla va...
Well, in France, it's the same. In France, in the southern part of France, in the Euroregion, the rich areas of investigation, so called the titles, in French, are in this phase of investigation only, and are relationated to these ones, with the volcanic system of the Jura, I think it's called here, and the deep basin of Nimes and the basin of Aquitaine, which we can see the concessions. Then, in the Euroregion, the expectative of a big project of deep geothermal. Goes from the hand of these kinds of explorations and lead areas, and the future is exactly what if they reach the exit again. On the other hand, the shallow geothermal brings us the opportunity to do our project in every ways without the need to have near a volcano or a spin thermal. Okay? This situation brings us the opportunity to study the area and with a depth study of the ground to control the great surfaces and to make a geological and hydrological prognosis. Also, the level of agricultural issues in every country, and we can, with the same investigation, we can start a more sophisticated reaction by thermal resource testing and hydraulic testing, and that. No, that is a degree of iteration and overlap between these three categories. The quantity and quality of existing acknowledgement about land conditions will determine how much additional setting creation is necessary. And at last, to know the shallow geothermal potential of our project area. This site investigation must be focused to the thermal geology to know the conductivity, the specific capacity, the temperature of ground, a relation with the climatic data, and finally the geothermal value. The temperature of ground is the temperature that the annual talks are early, about the 18 degrees in Barcelona. And we will look for the good conditions to make our geothermal, shallow geothermal project. Because the thermal conductivity is the material ability to test the potential movement of head through a material and it is controlled by a constant. Another property, physical property, is specific head capacity, and is the is the capacity of storage head of material. We can see the difference between materials. Here, the water can keep total energy of 1 cubic meter of sand, of rock. Then, if we increase 1 degree centigrade, this material. We need an amount of energy to this amount of energy to increase 1 degree centigrade, this volume of rock. Then, if we compare volumetric head capacity and thermal conductivity, we can see how water has a very high volumetric head capacity and low conductivity. After we will see the relation, the constant relationship. Yeah. And the volumetric head capacity depends by the temperature. But in thermogeology, in shallow geothermality, that it isn't important. Okay? We move in a range of values that we don't consider the change in phase of the materials and the change in intensity of the materials. Okay? The change in phase is considered in the head pump with the hacks, but in thermogeology, we move in this range of values. Calcite is limestone, clay, granite, copper, ethanol, bitumen, and the highest conductivity is copper or diamond. Diamond has 500 watts per metric calorie, meter calorie. If we expand this topic with a chart that is a resume of different authors, it is a chart to work with shallow geothermal. In this column we have thermal conductivity, and in this one we have volumetric head capacity. You have rocks and sediments here, minerals and materials. For example, in minerals, quartz, it has a 7.7 thermal conductivity quality, and then it's the upper, it's the best material to conductivity, to conduct the heat through a material. Then the worst, maybe, the worst is there, or limestone. This kind of table is a little bit tricky to take the decision. If I have under the sand factory, I have limestone, I have 1.5 and 3.0. But it also says limestone is, if it is massive, I have 2.8, then, well, in the middle. The best way is to take the middle, okay? But you can see how we are working with very very exact numbers and with very natural materials that we can find in the garden and next class, and we don't need volcanoes and something like that. Okay. Another example of this. Properties of materials. We have water at 0.6, but if water is cooled and it's converted to ice, it goes to 1.7. Okay. Then that property in Sweden, it's they ice the borehole to make ice and work with ice by water. Okay. And finally, the diffusivity is the is the ability of a material to conduct thermal energy relative to its ability to store thermal energy. In resume, the thermal diffusivity gives us the contamination of the heat by the borehole. When we heat a borehole or cold it, we subtract or inject parts in the underground. And the velocity that the different boreholes interact each other, it is controlled by thermal diffusivity. Okay? Interact between boreholes and interact between the neighbors. And the other head pump, the other installation of the of our neighbor, for example. Until now, we have been talking about this area. We have seen how faults, rifts, gravels, volcanoes control this head flux of the geothermal head flux. Our anomalies can put a fault here, and I can catch hot water here. But our anomaly is our reality. If I have not full, I have not hot water. I have that this interaction. Okay. The geothermal flux 0.09 watts per square meter, constant, 40 hours a day, at human scale. All of the year, I have this flux of heat. And in Catalonia, Institut Geològic de Catalunya has compiled this map of head flux. And you can see how the rift systems that make thinness the lithosphere makes the high flux in this area. And after we will see a case study of this phenomenon. Well, upstream in the surface we have another actor in shallow geothermal that is sand. Okay? Sand that can give us 10 watt meters per square meter. It's very highest than the geothermal head flux. Then the upper part of the survey is controlled by sand, and 105 per square meter. Here it is the capacity of heat of the sun on the surface, and we have this area that has like a huge solar deposit of heat. Okay? And if the heat and if the sun and it is the variability of the gradient, it is related to the hours of sun of the day of the year stations.
Excuse me. According to you, the slide before, what is the depth of the zone of seasonal fluctuation?
Yeah. Because good question. It is an escalable graph, but more or less at 10 meters, 40 meters, we have a constant temperature.
Okay. At middle temperatures, we use internal heat, and stop from 0 to 10, we use external heat.
Yeah. Yeah. 40, 10, okay? And the shallow geothermal, the principle of shallow geothermal, the idea is interact with this thermal gradient for longevity and environmental friendly and economical cheap to interact with this gradient. This is the objective of shallow geothermal. It is not to extract watts and cold the soil and heat the soil. Is to work joint with the earth. Okay. Well, that the interaction with sun surface it is controlled by the climate, and here we can see the first constraints to shallow geothermal and to see the potential of the shallow geothermal. We can see how if we have air under our feet, we have no potential because fire, air, it is very low conductivity. We cannot work with air, okay? But we cannot work with tropical climates, it's not visible because it's too hot, okay? And there are problems of humidity, okay? We need work with temperatures that the air is condensed in the buildings and it is not feasible. In arid climates, it is not feasible because the ground source head pumps not feasible because it is too hot and the efficiency of the head pumps need source of temperature more lower than we can find in an arid system. But in night we can storage the cold night air in a UTS that is an underground thermal storage system like a deposit, and to collect from the night to the day the coldest temperature. And another climate, well, here we can see the Euroregion climates, Mediterranean. can see how the runoff of heat pump becomes more and more interesting. But be aware with Mediterranean, because it's eco-occasionally feasible. We can storage, but some Mediterranean climates with hot, very hot episodes in summer makes the heat pump too low the efficiency, the cost. That Daniel talks about. A climate, marine oceanic common climate, is feasible, like a mini Pyrenees, for example, or Languedoc or Roussillon, I think, or in the internal concrete, the internal part of Catalonia. And clearly, continental climates are very feasible for heat pumps and seasonal storage and coal. Why happened that? Because in the x-axis, you can see the temperature of the air. In this case, it's the temperature of our borehole. It's the temperature of our drill. Okay, we have this borehole driller here, and this is the temperature, and this is the comfort zone of people, and we might. Living in this area when we are working or studying or living in this area, and this is the cost of the heat pump, and this is the capacity, the thermal power of heat pump. The thermal power increase with the needs of comfort, and increase with the need of comfort, rejecting heat in the building or extracting heat in the building. Then the heat pump, the cost is better in as close as the temperatures are with our comfort zone. Okay? The heat pump don't like extreme temperatures. Then our hole, it has a constant temperature and is interesting to work. But what happens with boreal climates, very extreme climates, it is far away of our comfort zone, then the heat pump need to bring from this temperatures of borehole to here. Then the work is harder, and the cost is very low, and then it is not visible. A little bit more visible is oceanic climate with a chilly winter and a cold summer. We can put a heat pump that work with a high cost, and we can work at the end. We work with a middle cost, very interesting. But with a supplement of a boiler, gas boiler, for example, or a very efficient heat pump. In another climate, continental, like maybe Pyrenees, a continental climate is extreme climate in winter and in summer, and is perfect for our purpose. It is in the middle, it brings the opportunity to work with a high cop and winter, and a high cop in summer, and balance the work between summer and winter, and we can reach the equilibrium under our in the underground. In the same steps, it is move the Mediterranean climate, but be careful, because we have a warm winter. We work with a very high cost, with a very high thermal power. It's very interesting, but if we uh, if, summon is very hot. We work with COPs very, very low, and we cannot compensate the heat expected from winter. And the results of that is that we could warm the underground. Okay, but this is a graphic representation about of Europe, and in the our zone we have oceanic climate here, continental, Mediterranean, continental temperate, and back here in Mallorca, very, very Mediterranean climate, with hot summers. In this area of Catalonia, very hot summers, and we see this area with a winter calcium to implementate the terms of the systems. A recent work in Europe is the Thermomap project. They resume the annual mean temperature of soil level. Okay, you can see how the temperature of soil level is warmest in this area, and it's coldest in these ones. But I say this is a project by with the partners, with country partners of France, Germany, Italy, England, but it is not Spain, because they finish the scale in 60 degrees centigrade, and we have, for example, a fabric also, the 18, and we need to know how many degrees are in Mallorca, for example,
19.9,
yeah. In Barcelona, we can reach 21, for example, but as a product of the urban contamination, for the buildings, for the parkings, the contamination with the underground, and we can reach 21, for example. And well, we must keep in mind that the reality of the climate and the average temperature of the underground, okay, for our south region. Well, we finished the site investigation, and this methodology of thermal response test, we can measure the partial initial average ground temperature, the geothermal gradient, the effective thermal conductivity, volumetric head, capacity of rock, workload, thermal resistance, and diffusivity. With all of this data, with the building data, we can see the potential of our project. Installed capacity of South Geothermal System. That's very interesting because, as I told before, only the electricity it is on the main area of investigation by the mining enterprise are very few, and it is on the exploration phase, and we have only 7% of implementation, another 3% of direct use, district heating, for example, Germany, something in this place, we can catch water at 40 degrees or 50 degrees and heat the roofings with that. But the great part of the geothermal is the shallow geothermal, 63%. And as we can see in the next chart, the capacity of French, for example, is 80,000 megawatts thermics, and Spain 150 megawatts thermics. But in number of units, France 18,000 and 8,000 units of heat pumps, France, and Spain, I think 800 or 1,000 units. Check, yeah. There's a little bit problem with the statistics in Spain, because I think the funds are here. And the graphic, we're in the soil. The reason there are not any more regulations. Step by step, let's see, step by step, the shallow geothermal potential by different items and with phase to okay? With geothermal flux, in Catalonia, for example, we can see this example in a rift deep granite site with a head flux, with a high head flux. This example is located in Vallès. It's a residential building with heat demand only. The heat pump has a capacity of 50 kilowatts. And when we did the thermogeology, we see this gradient of the borehole until 100 meters, reaching 50 degrees. Okay. This is a good conductivity material, granite, and clearly we can see the influence of the anomaly of the gas that is provoked by the thinnest lithosphere in this area. Okay. And it's for the owner, it's cheaper, the geothermal is cheaper to do because we have an anomaly by geothermal flux. By hydrogeology, sorry for France, I didn't find any data. By hydrogeology, we can expect shallow potential sites for shallow geothermal, with the extensive aquifers and very, very permeable, like Mallorca and France. Here in Mallorca, work I did last year, this is a refurbished hotel with heat and cool demand that is 300 kilowatts of capacity, and the project has the objective to drill 4,000 linear meters. But the problem is the poor conductivity of material that is porous limestone, it's a red shell of calcareous with iron, and after the study of thermogeology, we can see the potential of the shallow geothermal that increased sharply thanks to the hydrogeological conditions, because we can extract first 50 watts per meter, but if we increase the capacity of extraction heat to 70 watts per meter, we reach rapidly an equilibrium with the inlet and outlet temperatures, thanks that water works to translate the heat upstream. Another place. We think that's the rock. Then we can do the shallow geothermal thanks to the water. But this is an example very a little bit. But the our source of heat or pool is the sea water, and it is a factory of oyster, and then when they reach a goal of 4.4 thanks to the seawater exchange directly, and it is another shallow geothermal jungle, but this is the only that I think in the zone of angular pressure. Another example by climate. By climate, as we seen before, the climate, for example, in this area is continental and oceanic. We reach 30 degrees and 20 degrees in summer.
Linear meters with simultaneous heating and cooling,
they reach high costs. Every building is independent. Thanks to this good conductivity, granite matter space, and the space width for the world health sectors that can compensate the Mediterranean climate, that it's a little bit warmer, but if we have wet space, we can reject hot in the subsoil without penalties, okay? But we need more space then. And this is the technical room of one of these buildings, okay? The technical room is the first one that is this, not this. And it is a buried geothermal system room with no combustion, noiseless, no head air to the atmosphere, no visual perturbance, and no chimney. And that is very interesting for the modernist building. Finally, we have the our plan recommendation. In the left you can see France, and in the right you can see Spanish recommendation. We have a Code Minier, Ley de Minas, a Code of the Environment, Ley de Minas y Ley de Ambiente, Real Decreto. This is the law. Okay. And these are the rules. The rules are more implemented in France, not in the peaks, it's for us a lot. Very tough. Incoming in Spain, only this one, as it is incoming. And accreditations and certifications, we have in France. The PAC, COLIPAC, COLIFORAGE, COPAC, and the Association Française pour la Geothermie, Professional for Geothermie. They work very hard with the Geognition for la Geothermie, and it's a little bit it's very interesting, they work. And in Spain, you have Geotecnica, Manda Permitación, Geoplus, after quality certification, but they are very connected to each other. There is a connection with them.
Great.
That's all.
Only in deltas,
rivers, you can reach very long water systems. Okay? But that, from the Committee of Geologists, we propose to not be afraid with these kinds of situations. We can control it with piezometers. For example, in São Paulo, we can put a piezometer and control the temperature in the low water level and gain experience and to the future. Okay? For that, we need to know how we are working and to know that the geothermal has the constraints. Because it will. And you can work with our volume of rock.
Yes.
You can work with the volume of water of rock with the name.
Exactly. And I don't know if from University of Balearic Islands they are interested in that, because I know that I think in Menorca you have two layers of underground water, right? And one is polluted, the first one, and the second is not. In these cases, for example, what is the good proposal? Because since now I heard that the best option is just to drill in the depth that you don't reach the second underground water level.
Yeah. Well, the drills of geothermals looks for linear meters, dingy linear meters, crossing 1, 2, 3 layers of groundwater, because you have confined space to walk. Then I need 500 meters, and then I need to cross all of this area. Okay. And in the north of Europe, they work. They have sedimentary materials, and they work without grouting the borehole. They work only with one drill, and without cement, they put the polyethylene pipes, and then nothing more. Okay, that the culture that in the southern Europe we need to change, because we cross continental layers of water and we cannot cross one layer from with another, because that is very dangerous, not very neat. Okay, and it is a balance. To make the drill and to be environmentally friendly and to do the thing.